guys. Welcome back to the Esther Effect. I'm really excited. I had someone ask to talk about speaking in tongues, and I've read so much about this, and we talk about this a lot at school, and I have a lot of personal experiences. If you guys have heard of John Paul Jackson, one of his stories, dreams that he had, and John Bevere talks a lot about it. I read his Holy Spirit book, which I love, I recommend. So this beginning part is a lot about what John Bevere talks about, which I really, really love, and that really stuck with me as soon as I read it. It's his Holy Spirit book. I would definitely recommend reading that book because the beginning part of what I'm gonna talk about is from that book. He just talks about that there's four different ways to pray in tongues. Two are private and two are public. It actually says in 1 Corinthians 14:22, praying in tongues as a sign, not for believers, but unbelievers. And he gives the example of one of his staff members was in a meeting and she was in the back and she just felt like she was supposed to, she just felt this unction. She had to pray in tongues. She didn't know, she just needed to pray. After a little bit of the message, one of the guys stood up and he turned and looked at her and said, "Wow, you were praying in perfect French. I've never heard this ancient, it's like an ancient dialect of French. And every time John said one of the verses, you prayed it in perfect French before he said the verse." And he was like, "That's so amazing. Your dialect is perfect. Your accent, everything is perfect." She's like, "I don't speak French. I've never spoke French in my life." That was a sign unto him. That's actually a public displays of speaking in tongues. Another public is for interpretation, and it's in a heavenly language. So it's a language of heaven, it's not on this earth. And it says in 1 Corinthians 12:28 through 30, "Are all not apostles, are all not prophets, teachers, workers of miracles? Do all work gifts of healings? Do all speak in tongues? Do all interpret?" He's asking this question, but the answer is in 1 Corinthians 14:22 through 23. "Therefore, tongues for a sign," that was what the first one we talked about, "are a sign not to those who believe, but to unbelievers," what we just talked about. If the whole church comes together in one place and all speak with tongues, tongues for interpretation, which we're talking about now, which is a heavenly language, and there come in those who are uninformed or unbelievers, will they not all say you are out of your mind? So when you interpret, it's not like it's a direct translation like I just spoke about the woman speaking French. This is a heavenly language. When you hear a heavenly language, it's not going to be word for word translation, but it is interpreted. If you ever heard of interpreter, it's not word for word. But he gives the story of he was speaking right before when they were in worship. Somebody stood up and was praying in tongues. They basically said his whole message, what he was about to speak on, and she was praying it in tongues. Well, what she spoke it, and then she interpreted it. And that was basically John's whole message that he was about to preach on. So it coincides. So the Lord was speaking, the Holy Spirit was speaking with John's message, right? So it's for interpretation. Does that make sense? And then a private one. So those first two were public, displays of speaking in tongues. And the next two are private. So for personal prayer, and it says in 1 Corinthians 14:14-15, "For if I pray in a tongue, my spirit prays, but my understanding is unfruitful. What is the conclusion then? I will pray with the spirit, and I will also pray with the understanding. I will sing with the spirit, I will also sing with understanding." And it says in 1 Corinthians 14:2, that you're not speaking to men, but you're speaking to God. Jude 20 says, "But you, beloved, building yourselves up on your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Spirit." And it's so important because you're building yourself up and it's personal prayer to the Lord. So you're speaking the perfect will of God to him, which it came from him. And it's like you're praying it and you're echoing what he's downloading into your heart and you're sending it back up to him as worship unto him. And you're saying, "I agree with everything that you're saying and I want to do the same will, your will. Let your will be done," and you're praying the perfect will of God in your secret time and your personal time with the Lord. It's so powerful. It's so powerful, and it builds up your spirit man. My best friend and I, we would always say, you know, our spirit men are growing, and if that you could see our spirit man, we're like the Hulk and are busting out, our muscles are just crazy. Our spirit man's growing, praying in tongues. You can pray in tongues all the time. The Holy Spirit is available 24/7. He's the best teacher, comforter. If you have him, you have everything, you know? And so the last private way to speak in tongues is for intercession. It says in Romans 8, 26 through 27, likewise, the Spirit also helps in our weaknesses, for we do not know what we should pray for as we ought, but the Spirit himself makes intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. Now he who searches the hearts knows what the mind of the Spirit is, because he makes intercession for the saints according to the will of God. Intercession, we're praying for people. One time my mom, she would have chronic headaches. I just started praying for her, and as I prayed, actually the headache would move, which is the spirit of infirmity. I was praying in tongues, right? And then we prayed again, and then it moved, and it moved over here, and then we prayed and it was moving all over her head, and all of a sudden I just started weeping, and it was uncontrollable of why. And I just continued to pray in tongues, and I was bawling, crying, but I wasn't really thinking anything. My mind is unaware, like it says, your mind is just unaware, but I was praying into something that was going on with my mom, and I think it was a generational curse that was allowing the headaches to come in. And after I was praying for several minutes, you know, the headache broke off, and my mom was like, why are you crying? And I don't really know, but I knew it was something generational that was afflicting my mom, and it completely broke off. One of the stories I also heard from John Paul Jackson is he actually was in a vision, and the vision goes like this. There was a girl driving in her car. There were two demons just like sitting in her car with her, and all of a sudden she just started praying in tongues, and these two demons just started screaming. Now this is a vision that John Paul Jackson had, and he was watching this all play out, and the girl was unaware in the vision, and the demons just started screaming, and they're like, it burns, and so they were physically being burned when the girl was praying in tongues. And John Paul Jackson came out of the vision, and the Lord said, this is what happens when you pray in tongues. And the demons spoke in the dream, like one was a new demon, and they were like, what is going on? You know, why is this burning when this girl is whatever she's doing? And the other demon was like, it's because she's speaking directly to the enemy. They called the Lord the enemy. And so it was like physically burning the demon. Now whenever I'm praying in tongues, I'm actually physically, I know that it happened, because they flee when you do pray in tongues. Why it's so important that we do pray in tongues. We're not able to pray in tongues or in the spirit unless God lives inside us. Your brain is actually coming, what's cool is that your brain is actually coming to the conclusion that God lives inside you, because when you're praying in tongues, you're not always knowing what you're saying. Even the woman that spoke French, perfect French as her prayer language, she didn't know what she was saying, even though she was speaking an earthly dialect or an earthly language. She still had no idea in her mind. Some of the verses was John 16, 14 through 15, and 1 Corinthians 2, 10 through 12. Your spirit man knows that God is inside you, but your brain doesn't always realize that based on how you act in the world. When you're going out and you're praying for people, and if you're not sure that they're gonna get healed, or you're just trying to trust the Lord, your brain doesn't always believe that God is inside you. But when you pray in tongues, it actually makes your brain line up with your spirit. You're not created to live sober. You were created to live intoxicated in the presence of God. Acts 2:15 says, they are not drunk as you suppose. And I just was like, that's me! Because I felt that like so right when Dr. Carey said that, I was like, yep. The more you pray in the spirit, you become more and more emotionally stable. We're not given a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind. A lot of times we're not always sure about different areas. Sometimes you're more sure in some areas of your life, and then other areas you're still growing in. But when you're praying in tongues, it brings you into a sound mind. And he said, it accelerates your sonship understanding, which is so key, especially being at school. But I feel like we all can always come into more understanding of your son, understanding your place and your relationship with the Lord. Your spiritual language is the primary way that you can know God's purpose for you. Isn't that so key? Like, everybody's always wondering, even if they've stepped into maybe getting married or stepping into a business opportunity, they're always wondering, what is the next will based on this, just for business, what is the Lord's perfect will for my life? And you can understand that and you can step into that by praying in your prayer language. Someone that prays in tongues finds it much easier to hear God. I really hope that this encourages you like it encourages me. I would really encourage you to read that John Bevere Holy Spirit book. It's super, super awesome if you want to learn more about praying in tongues. I learned so much by reading that book. He just goes over that really quickly and then he just expounds on it more. But I really hope this encourages you. I love you so much. I'm always praying for you. We'll talk to you soon.